They diagnose sickness, prescribe medicine, and we're not talking about doctors, but they can often be just as important, especially in rural areas. In this case, that would be a family nurse practitioner.
And UND has been educating family nurse practitioners for more than two decades. LA News Team's Ashley Bishop joins us live from Grand Forks, where the program is celebrating this big anniversary. Good morning, Ashley.
Good morning, Kyle and Lisa. We're here at UND. We're actually in one of the classrooms where students learn how to be a family nurse practitioner. Joining me are two students right now in the program, Jenna and Eric. Eric, talk to me. Why did you want to be a family nurse practitioner?
Before I did my undergrad, I knew that I wanted to go into healthcare. I just kind of chose nursing as I didn't really know what I wanted to do, and I knew that it was kind of a broad field. You could do lots of different things. Then as I went in, I grew up in a rural community. I knew that they always, struggled to get providers. I knew that they didn't always have access to health care that the more urban communities would have. So I just decided, I think this is what I want to do, go back, give back to my community. So.
Okay, Jenna, the same. I mean, did you know that you wanted to do this from the beginning?
Yeah, I actually kind of did. I knew I wanted to be an NP probably since I declared nursing as a major. But same as Eric, there's such a need for practitioners to come back into the rural settings and that sort of thing. And so there's a lot of good jobs out there. It was just a good fit for me. You kind of get a little bit of everything. With what we're doing, we see babies all the way through elderly. And so it's just it's a lot of good variety, keeps it interesting, and that's why I chose it.
Now, you guys actually practice on dummies through school. You're kind of learning, and then you go into a clinic setting. But what can these dummies do? Is it just to learn where the heart is, or do they do more than that?
So this is a simulator, and this is probably one of the more basic ones that we have here, and the undergrad students use it a lot. But what we can do with this this simulator is it'll do vital signs, heart and lung sounds, normals, abnormals, that sort of thing, so the students can, and we can get used to hearing different sounds. We have some more advanced simulators. One can actually give birth. So there's just a lot of things these simulators can do prior to us going, to the clinic setting, and just so we can feel more comfortable with it, comfortable with our skills, and just hear the things that we may not, hear regularly, the abnormal things that we wouldn't, experience in the clinic. So
now, and I saw the one that can give birth, and it was looked lifelike.
Definitely.
Jenna, last question. Let me talk to you. You have a plan. You're going to be graduating in May, correct? Do you have a plan? You know where you want to go?
And not quite yet, a set in stone plan, but ultimately I would like to stay rural. It's, like I said, super high need. It's a lot of great jobs. And like I said, you get to see a little of everything. And so that's where I would like to stay, is more in the rural setting. So.
Okay. Coming up this morning, we're going to talk more about the program. It's turning 20 this year, and they have a great event coming up this October. We'll tell you more about that throughout the morning. Kyle, Lisa?
Thank you, Ashley. Ashley Bishop reporting live from UND this morning.